Why do everyday macroscopic objects not show quantum behavior? To answer this big research question, we take baby steps. We work with macroscopic objects, glass particles of only 150 nanometer diameter, but they already contain a few billions of atoms. To isolate them from environmental effects, we levitate them with a high-power laser beam, and we work at extremely low pressures. As a starting point, by making the light interact with particle, we can remove its emotional energy to the lowest level allowed by quantum mechanics, where it only moves a few picometers. It turns out that in our system, this interaction is so strong that it's a very interesting and exotic regime to study, and this is exactly what I do. As an experimentalist, I'm building a system that will allow us to reach and study this regime. Together with my colleagues, we planned optics and vacuum system, and my job now is to buy necessary equipment using group budget and assemble it into an apparatus that works. Impact of research on society is quite hard to predict. Fundamental research generally pushes technology forward, but when and how exactly it's going to happen is a big question. For example, our platform may be used as a very high sensitivity inertia sensor to study short-range interactions important in solid-state physics, or to study thermodynamics in quantum regime that may help make memories better. I wanted to expose myself to different educational systems, and that's why I changed countries of studies between bachelor, master's and PhD. From a professional perspective, it's very useful to adapt best work practices, and it's also good to see every country's scientific communities. University of Vienna I chose in particular because I really wanted to work with my current supervisor, Aspelmeyer, on experiments with levitated nanoparticles.